Sabi ni Kong Chua, swak sa kasong plunder ang halaga ng iniimbestigang pondo ng House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability kaugnay sa irregularidad sa paggamit ng budget ng tanggapan ni Vice President Sara Duterte. Ayan, baka makasuhan pa ng plunder. I must stress at this point that the sheer vastness of these potentially misused funds sets this matter apart from other instances of irregularity and disallowance. These amounts easily surpass the threshold for the crime of plunder under our laws. Ayan na nga ba. Kung kayo ay nasa US, UK, Canada, Italy, France, Spain, Ireland, and Belgium, ay pwede na po yung magpadala ng inyong mga remittance sa Pilipinas. Gamit po ang SendWave. Ang gagawin nyo lang ay download ng app. Gumawa kayo ng account, lagay niyo ba account details niyo at pwede na kayo magpadala sa GCash, Cash Pickup at iba't ibang mga bangko sa Pilipinas. At kapag ginamit niyo pa kayong promo code sa inyo pong unang padala ay makakuha kayo ng karagdagan $20 free credit. Kaya gamitin na si SendWave for all of your remittance needs. Yon!
Magandang magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. I would like to start by making some things very clear before we start the proceedings today. I have heard, and I assume many of us here have heard, accusations and insinuations regarding this committee and these proceedings, implying that this is somehow a political exercise or an attack on an individual. I would like to make things very clear. This is not the case. At this point, I will apologize to some of the people watching, as I will be mentioning a lot of numbers during my remarks. This is necessary in order to make clear that it is not any enmity, passion, or hostility which drives this committee. It is simply a case of numbers that do not make sense. This is why, if you would recall, last week's hearing focused on the issue of confidential funds. Ano ba ang confidential fund na ito at bakit ito importante? Ano ang kinalaman nito sa accountability? Based on Joint 2015-01 of the COA, confidential funds are funds disbursed to, among others, national government agencies for their confidential expenses. On the other hand, confidential expenses are those relating to surveillance activities which support the operations of the agency. So sa madaling salita, ang confidential funds ay pera para sa mga operasyon ng pagbabantay at pagmamanman ukol sa mga aktibidad ng ahensya. While this may seem to be a very specific definition, we cannot help but notice that the joint circular provides very loose requirements for the release of confidential funds to agencies and also requires less specific information and documents in order to liquidate and account for. In Notice of Disallowance number 2024-002-100, the COA disallowed the amount of over 73 million pesos.
Wow, laki.
Representing almost 60% of the 125 million pesos in confidential funds. Pwede po ba yung slide? Paki-present. Almost 60% of the 125 million pesos in confidential funds allocated to the OVP in 2022. Equally significant is the fact that this amount was indicated to have been fully spent over the period of 11 days. Wala pang kalahating buwan, naubos na daw ang 125 million.
Wow.
Supposedly to fund surveillance of 132 areas. This amounts to 11 million pesos spent per day. for these surveillance activities conducted over the holidays. Lumalabas po, mahigit 11 million po sa isang araw ang ginagastos po nila sa surveillance activities. Kasama na po dito ang Pasko. I note that while these numbers are already staggering, this is only a portion of what this committee is investigating and dealing with. In fiscal year 2023, the OVP received ₱500 million in confidential funds. This includes the 125 million mentioned above, disbursed in 2022. In addition to this amount, spent in 11 days, the OVP was disbursed 125 million per quarter for the first three quarters of 2023, the entirety of which has been questioned by the COA through Audit Observation Memorandum, o yung tinatawag po nating AOM. In other words, one of the 500 million we are talking about, only about 10% or 51 million has been definitively allowed by COA. Sa 500 million po, halos 10% lamang po ang pinayagan ng COA at sinabing walang problema.
Yun.
At ito po yung nagkakahalaga ng 51 million. When one goes deeper and looks at the liquidation reports for these disbursements, a disturbing pattern and similarity emerges with perfectly round numbers. Ni isang sentimo po ay walang butal. Being attributed to expenses such as medicine and food, paulit-ulit po at parang kinapipaste ang liquidation ng confidential funds ng OVP. With this in mind, to all but the most biased observers, it should be very easy to see why this committee has chosen to investigate the possibility of gaps in the regulation of confidential funds, as it is possible that we have seen these gaps exploited before our very eyes.
Correct. Agree.
What we have seen regarding the usage by the OVP of its confidential funds certainly gives this committee and the country cause to want to find out the facts behind this. Ultimately, to fulfill this August body's mandate of crafting effective laws and legislations to protect our people's hard-earned money. This committee is understandably very alarmed at these reports implying misuse of public funds. In particular, because of the astronomical, almost unimaginable amount of money involved.
Laki.
I must stress at this point that the sheer vastness of these potentially misused funds sets this matter apart from other instances of irregularity and disallowance. These amounts easily surpass the threshold for the crime of plunder under our laws.
Patay. Tutuloy natin mamaya, pag-usapan natin.
It is incumbent upon us who are duty-bound to ensure that our legislation and regulations are effective enough to protect the money of the people, to investigate and get to the bottom of these glaring irregularities. As we begin today's hearing, I must make this clear. This committee is not about politics, not about attacks. It is not even about the release or approval of any budget, as some have implied. This investigation is not prompted by any motive other than a desire to make the numbers make sense. This committee and these proceedings are about accountability. We seek to learn the truth of how public money, ang pera ng taong bayan, is being used, whether or not our current laws, rules, and procedures are sufficient to ensure the security and safety of these funds. Maraming salamat po.
Yun. Allergic si Sarah doon sa salitang accountability. It is a crime. Oo, it's a crime po. O, krimen po ang plunder. Hindi lang po siya unconstitutional, it is a crime. Well, basically, plunder is pagnanakaw. Nagnakaw ng pera sa kaba ng bayan sa halagang 50 million pesos. Ikaw ay nag-commit na ng plunder. Yun. Yun po yun. Ano po ang kaparusahan? Ang kaparusahan po dito ay reclusion perpetua to death. So, ano po to, mabigat. Mabigat ang penalty dito. Eh, wala nang death penalty sa Pilipinas. So, reclusion perpetua. Kulong ng panghabang buhay. Or 40 years. Maximum. Pero syempre, depende pa yan kung gaano karaming counts. Ilang counts ng plunder yun. So, kung tatlong counts yun, o di 120 years. Ganon. Tapos, yung mga kakonspiracy niya, any person who participated with the said public officer in the commission of an offense contributing to the crime of plunder shall likewise be punished for such offense. So, damay silang lahat. So, yung mga conspirators niya, sama-sama sila. Okay, in the imposition of penalties, the degree of participation and attendance of mitigating and extenuating circumstances as provided by the RPC shall be considered. So, meron pa rin mga titignan na mitigating circumstances. The court shall declare any and all ill-gotten wealth in their interest and other incomes and assets, including the properties and shares of stocks derived from the deposit or investment thereof, forfeited in favor of the state. So, maakotsera, ano po ang keyword dito sa plunder? Sa krimen po ng plunder? Keyword po dito, mga kutsero, ay ito. Amasses, accumulates, or acquires ill-gotten wealth. Yan po ang keyword dyan. Ibig sabihin, direktang maituturo ng itaong ito, in this case, let's say, si Sara Duterte, si Sara Duterte ay nagbulsa ng pera. So medyo ano, para sa akin mga kutsero, agree ako sa sinabi ni Kong Chua na nalampasan niya yung threshold ng plunder. Kasi ang threshold ng plunder is 50 million pesos lang. Oo. Eh ano yung sa confidential funds niya? Sa confidential funds niya, ito pa lang eh, sa DepEd eh. 12 billion. Sa DepEd pa lang yan. 12 billion in suspension, disallowances, and charges. Sekretary ka ng DepEd. Or ikaw ay Office of the Vice President. Di ba? Yun ang opisina mo. Duty mo yun eh. Is accountable for public funds or property? Accountable siya sa confidential funds. Di ba? Siya yung gumagastos eh. Shall appropriate the same or shall take or misappropriate or shall consent or through abandonment or negligence. Ibig sabihin, na sobrang tanga mo, nagastos mo ng mali. Ganon. Na sobrang ano mo, negligent mo, sa sobrang hindi ka marunong, either voluntary or involuntary, eh nagastos mo siya ng mali. Shall permit any other person to take such public funds or property, wholly or partially, or shall otherwise be guilty of the misappropriation or malversation of public funds. So, baka mas madali ito. Baka mas madali ito. Kasi meron kang, pwede mo siyang iilusot sa negligence eh. Oo. Pwedeng criminal negligence, sinadya mo, na i-misappropriate. Pwede rin simple negligence. Diba? Wala ka talagang alam. Hindi mo ano, hindi ka nag-conduct ng due diligence. You did not apply the legal requirement of diligence, which is that of a father taking care of his family. Pwede mong ilusot. Mas madali sa malversation. Pero syempre, mas mababa din ang penalty. Mas mababa din ang penalty niya. Oh. Penalty of prison correctional for amounts involving not exceeding 200 pesos. Prison mayor kung hindi exceed ng 6,000 pesos. Prison mayor in its maximum to reclusion temporal kung lalampas ng 12,000. Reclusion temporal in its medium and maximum if involves more than 12,000 pesos but is less than 22,000 pesos. Diba? If the amount exceeds the latter, the penalty shall be reclusion temporal in its maximum period to reclusion perpetua. 73 million. So, pwede na dito yon. Pwede siyang reclusion temporal to reclusion perpetua. Unlike sa plunder, reclusion perpetua talaga yon. Pero dito, meron ka pang reclusion temporal. So, hanggang 20 years. 10 to 20 years if I'm not mistaken. So, may ano ka pa. Meron ka pang leeway no, na 10 to 20 years. Excuse me. So, yun. Baka mas madali ito. Malversation of public funds. Baka. Baka lang naman. Of course, I'm not yet a lawyer. But, baka lang naman. Mas madali. Mas madali mo may argue dito yung negligence. Eh. So, but that's just me. So, but the fact of the matter is, mga kutsero, wag ko tayong magpapabulag. Wag ko tayong magpapabulag. Kasi ilang lagi nilang sinasabi, ni Sarah, walang misuse of public funds. Okay, walang problema. There's no misuse of public funds. How? Paano mo nasabi na walang misuse of public funds eh hindi ka nga umaapir sa mga hearing? Diba? How can you say that? How can you say that? We don't know. Tayo mga Pilipino, hindi natin alam. So, ayan mga kutsero, maraming po salamat sa inyong patuloy na pagsuporta sa ating channel. Huwag niyo po kalimutan mag-like, mag-share, at subscribe sa Coach Jared YouTube channel. May follow tayo sa ating page. Jared Pulido ang pangalan. And I'll see all of you tomorrow sa ating next Coach Jared Live. God bless. We'll see you next time, guys. Bye! Pag ganun, huwag natin gawing tanga mga Pilipino. Mas maganda kasi nasa lugar ka ng tama kaysa yung pinipilit mo yung pagkakamali. Are they willing to go that far? Hindi makakalimutan ng Pilipino yan hanggat di nasasagot niya. Sino ngayon nagsasabi ng totoo?